The ratio of the number of turns in the secondary to the number of turns in the primary is called the turns ratio. Since transformers have a unity coefficient of coupling, the voltage induced in each turn of the secondary is the same as the voltage self-induced in each turn of the primary. Let's demonstrate with some examples. In this example, 8 volts across the primary of 8 turns results in an induced voltage per turn of 1 volt. Since the secondary has 4 turns, the secondary voltage is 4 volts. Another example, if the turns were 10,000 in the secondary and 1,000 in the primary, then the turns ratio would be 10 to 1. Therefore, the secondary voltage would be 10 times greater than the primary voltage. Now let's add primary voltage and a load resistance of 1,000 ohms. If the primary voltage is 10 volts AC, then the secondary voltage would be 10 times 10 volts, or 100 volts AC. If a 1,000 ohm load were placed across the secondary, then the secondary current, according to Ohm's law, would be E secondary divided by R sub L, or 100 volts, divided by 1,000 ohms, which equals 100 milliamps. The secondary winding acts as an AC source to R sub L,